It's all about the timing of how that thing is going to mesh up with those five guys in front and with the quarterback. Good. You look at 32 right there. See his first step, see how it's back. I don't like that as much, but what I do like is how square his shoulders stay. He squares up, and that's a guy that will see holes and be patient with how he runs the zone. Again, I'm going to be the read guy. If you're a zone read team out of the gun where you're reading the defensive end, gets a chance to do that. But again, if the quarterback hands the football, he's still going to have to catch a ball out here. I want that guy having to get the idea of catching, tucking the football away, maintaining that aspect of it. Now on this, notice it hasn't changed that much, but this is our setup. If you notice, this is set at an angle. This one's back squared up, okay? So you can move these around and do what you want to. For us, this is a power. As we're talking about the power, we're always talking about, yes, I do want to find that guard, and I want to know who's moving with you. More importantly for us is, where is that wash happening, right? Where is that down block and that wash going to happen for your running back? If you can teach him where that part of it is going to be, if I can stay tight to the wash, I can get on the hip of that guard and he's going to get up in there. If something funky happens with him, I can still make yards by finding the wash of where that power is going to happen. All right, so stay tight to the wash, get on his hips, and then from that point, you just got to use the instincts and play. But again, if you notice, nothing changes backfield-wise from our zone to our power and the steps that the running back's doing.